What's up, legends? It's Michał and welcome back to Made Up Universe. Avengers Endgame are back in cinemas this weekend with additional content? What? Kevin Feige, during the press junket in London for Spider-Man Far From Home, has revealed that this weekend, Avengers Endgame will be back in cinemas with additional content. There's apparently 7 minutes of additional content and also a tribute to Stan Lee. What's going on, Marvel? What is all this? One might ask this question, but the other one, the more knowledgeable one, knows exactly what it is. It is a chase. It is a chase for the first place of the highest grossing movie of all time. And this chase is against the Avatar. And Avengers Endgame are sitting just 40 something millions away from this record. And obviously, Marvel Studio wants people to go back to the cinema. And what is the better way to bring them back to the cinema if not additional content? I mean, come on! This is so well played. How did they came up with that though? How was that planned before, or did they just within the last couple of weeks jumped into edits? I mean, how did they do that? Because like, I think the score is made when the final edit is ready? I mean, I don't know. Did they plan for that? Did they plan ahead? Did they knew that this might happen? Or did they just made it a couple of weeks ago? I would love to find out. What do you guys think? I want to hear from you as well. So what do I think about this whole situation? Where there are two things I think about this whole situation. The first one is that I think it's a really nice fan service because, you know, we've dedicated so much time and effort and all, and they give us this additional content and provided it's a good content, it's a nice content and something really worthwhile going for, it's a nice thing to do. And the Stanley tribute, of course, like, you know, they know what they're doing, right? This isn't some bullshit. They know exactly what they're doing. They know, like, when you talk about Stanley, Marvel fans go like bonkers. Obviously that's a good thing, and this is an obvious attempt at scoring a little bit more money and beating that record. I don't blame them, you know. If I were them, I would love to break that record, and to be honest, I would love this movie to break that record. The second thing though is that I've no idea, absolutely no idea, if I'm gonna have a time to actually go and watch it, because my wedding is in like 3 weeks and I've got weekends busy. I'm busy at work and busy with all kinds of different shit at the moment, and I honestly, truthfully, don't know if I'll be able to see Avengers Endgame with additional content. And obviously this is another great thing that Marvel is doing, because just before the release of Spider-Man, they're steering the pod, they're creating hype, people are going to start talking about Marvel again just before the release of Spider-Man Far From Home, therefore creating more hype for the other movie. It's all brilliantly played. Well done, Marvel. And obviously I'd really want to find out what this additional content is, and if I have an opportunity, I'm gonna go and see it and I'm gonna let you know what I thought about this. But I'm hoping it's good. Obviously I want to hear from you guys. Are you excited about this opportunity, or do you think that is going over the board by Marvel and trying to grab that additional $45 million? So hit the comment section below, let me know, and as always, if you enjoyed this video, subscribe to my channel. I talk about Marvel, Star Wars, toys, all kinds of geeky shit. And obviously when you subscribe to my channel, hit the bell notification button to stay up to date with all my videos. And as always, see you next time in the Made Up Universe.